Welcome to the session. Today I am going to explain you about the first PUC syllabus under the biological classification. Under biological classification, in the last class we dealt about the kingdom Mycota or fungi. The continuation of that fungi or mycota is, in the previous class I explained about the key features or the salient features or unique features of the fungi, and up to asexual reproduction I explained only the one which left in the last class was the sexual cycle. Remember, in fungi the sexual phase is unique. The sexual reproduction involves the following three steps. Here in fungi there is both asexual and sexual reproduction. They are alternate with each other. The sexual cycle includes plasmogamy, karyogamy, and then the meiosis. Now let us know one by one. What is plasmogamy? Plasmogamy is nothing but the fusion between the protoplasm of two gametes, that is both male and female gamete. Whether they are motile or non-motile, it is immaterial. Here remember, plasmogamy, gamy means gametes. Plasmo in the sense that is nothing but the matrix of that gamete, that is the protoplasm. The fusion between the protoplasm of the two gametes, the male and female, whether motile or non-motile, is called plasmogamy. Suppose this is one gamete and this is the another gamete, the fusion between these two is the plasmogamy. Here observe, the two protoplasm of the male and female gamete is fused, that is the plasmogamy. Then karyogamy. Karyogamy in the sense, karyon means what? Nucleus. Gamy means gamete. Karyogamy means it is the fusion of the two nuclei of the gametes. So suppose this is the plasmogamy and this is what is known as the karyogamy. The gametic nucleus, as you are aware, is haploid. The two haploid gametic nuclei fuse together forming a diploid nucleus, and the cell is called the zygote. The zygote is diploid because it is formed by the fusion of two haploid gametic nuclei. Hence it is the diploid cell. So the karyogamy and the plasmogamy ultimately result in the formation of what? A zygote. The zygote is what? A diploid one. In the zygote, or the resultant zygote undergo what? Meiosis, not mitosis, remember. As meiosis occurs in the zygote, meiosis, I hope you know that it is a reductional division. The diploid cell becomes what? Haploid by meiosis. Hence, whenever the zygote undergone the meiosis, naturally results in what? Haploid cells. And those haploid cells are nothing but what? The haploid spores. And one thing you have to remember here is, in some lower the fungi like phycomycetes, the plasmogamy is soon followed by karyogamy. That is followed by the formation of the zygote, which in turn followed by what? Meiotic division, resulting in the formation of haploid spores. So this occurs one after the other without a delay in lower fungi like phycomycetes, but in the higher fungi like the ascomycetes and even said to be the basidiomycetes, the plasmogamy is not soon followed by karyogamy. To certain extent, the two nuclei, though the protoplasm is fused, resulting in what? Plasmogamy. The two nuclei found in one cell like this for considerable length of time, and this condition is called what? Dikaryon or dikaryotic stage. Here it is, it completed what? Plasmogamy, but not karyogamy. As a result, the two haploid nuclei of the gametes remain as such, and that stage can be referred as dikaryon or dikaryotic stage. And of course, later on, the two nuclei fused together, forming what? Karyogamy. And then the karyogamy resulted in the formation of the zygote, and then by meiosis it formed the haploid spores. So overall we can say that in the primitive or in the lower fungi like phycomycetes, plasmogamy very soon followed by karyogamy, and then it is followed by the formation of the zygote. Zygote undergoes meiotic division, resulting in the formation of haploid spores. That is almost a continuous process. But in the higher fungi, the plasmogamy is not soon followed by the karyogamy. Between these two, there is another stage by name dikaryotic stage. That means here the two haploid nuclei remain as such without undergo fusion for considerable length of the time. And later on, of course, both of them fuse together, resulting in the formation of karyogamy, and the remaining process is same as good as in the lower fungi. That is the sexual cycle, which is a unique feature in case of what? The mycota or fungi. Now, let us know about the next is classification of the fungi. The kingdom Mycota is classified into four classes. One is phycomycetes, second one is ascomycetes, the third one is the basidiomycetes, and last one is deuteromycetes. Now let us go one by one. First of all, let us take up the phycomycetes. As I said earlier, phycomycetes is the lower form of fungi. What are phycomycetes? They are nothing but algal fungi. Phyco refers to what? Algae. Study of algae is called what? Phycology. Mycetes refers to the fungus. So hence it is commonly called as algal fungi. Then the members of the phycomycetes may be what? Parasites or saprophytes. They may be parasites or the saprophytes. Parasites in the sense, because they depend upon what? The host for its survival. For example, albugo. This is nothing but what? Parasitic fungus which causes a disease in mustard plant. Or saprophyte, that means those which grow on the dead and decaying matter of plants or animal or even on what? Food stuffs. For example, if you observe the bread, if at all the bread is kept for a longer period of time in the open air, whenever it gets the moisture, naturally after few days you can see either white mass or black mass on that bread piece. That is nothing but what? Fungal infection. That is fungal infection. So that means here it grows on what? That matter, food stuff. That is the saprophyte. For example, rhizopus. That is nothing but bread mold. Next is regarding the mycelium. Remember, mycelium is the body of a fungus. That mycelium contains several filamentous structures called what? The hyphae. Hyphae. Hyphae is singular, hyphae is plural. Or the network of the hyphae can be referred as what? Mycelium. Or in other words, mycelium is the body of fungus containing several filamentous structures called hyphae. The hyphae is of two types. Observe here, suppose this is one of the hyphae. You may come across the hyphae like this. Or you may come across the hyphae like this. What may be the difference between these two? That is one and two. In the first case, you observe the here there are said to be the septal walls or cross walls separating the cells from one another. Suppose the septal walls are present like this, then it is called septate hyphae. Now observe here, there are no septal walls or the cross walls between the nuclei. Here the nuclei is what? Distributed all along its length. Then such a condition can be called as what? Aseptate, or even called cenocytic condition. Cenocytic. If there are no septal walls, then it is aseptate. If at all there are septal walls, it is septate. That is the hyphae. What is hyphae? A filamentous structure of mycelium. What is mycelium? It is nothing but the body of a fungus. Observe here, mycelium is branched. Branched in the sense, it appears like this. Like this. And then, aseptate, that means no septal wall. As there is no septal wall, such a condition can be referred as what? Cenocytic condition, where the nuclei is distributed or spread out with no cross walls. That is the one. Then asexual reproduction occurs by the motile zoospores. Motile zoospores in the sense, that means they have the mobility or motility. Or non-motile haplanospores or conidiospores like that. These are all what? Asexual reproductive bodies. And the sexual reproduction occurs by what? Conjugation. In the previous classes itself, I explained you about the conjugation, which is nothing but a primitive type of the sexual reproduction where the two cells come together and exchange their nuclear material. By conjugation, it forms what? Zygospores. Here, the two cells serve as what? Gametes. These gametes may be the isogametes or anisogametes or oogametes like that. If at all the two gametes are similar in size, shape, and in everything or in every aspect, then it is called isogametes. If at all the two gametes, that is the male and the female, are dissimilar, then it referred as what? Anisogamous or oogamous. Remember, the difference between the anisogamous and oogamous is, in anisogamous, either the male gamete is smaller or female gamete is the smaller. Whereas, the another one, the male or female is said to be the smaller and the larger like that. That means, if at all the male gamete is smaller, then the female gamete is supposed to be larger. If the male gamete is larger, then the female gamete is smaller like that. That means, in the anisogamous condition, either the male or the female is smaller or larger like that. But in the oogamous type, the male gamete is smaller, whereas the female gamete is quite larger. Here, the male is never be larger. That is the difference. Anyhow, both the conditions are what? Dissimilar gametes. That is, the regarding the iso, anisogamous, and oogamous type. The typical example for this is what? The mucor. This also grows on bread. And the rhizopus. Bread mold, albigo, that is parasitic fungus on mustard plant. Here, they regarding the rhizopus, observe this is supposed to be the rhizopus, and here these are said to be the hyphae. Here in the hyphae, this one is aseptate. As it fixes the fungus to the substratum, it is called rhizoidal hyphae. Rhizoidal. As it runs all along the length or all along the surface of the earth, it is called stola. The one which grows vertically is called sporangiopore. Observe, sporangiopore is nothing but a stalk-like structure which bears a sac-like structure called sporangium. And in this sporangium, what are phloem? That is the spores. Here actually the spores are phloem. The production of the spores is by asexual method. And the formation of the zygospore is by sexual method. Here the asexual and the sexual generation alternate with each other. This is the rhizopus, what the diagram I have written here. And it is commonly known as what? Bread mold. That means it grows on the bread whenever there is moisture content. That is the one. Now, let us pass on to the next day class. That is ascomycetes. Remember, ascomycetes are commonly called as what? Sac fungi. What do you mean by a sac? Sac is nothing but a bag-like structure or a packet-like structure. So why it is called as a sac fungi? Because the ascospores are developed in the bag-like structures called the asci. Asci means sac. That's why they are called sac fungi. The nature is, they may be saprophyte. As I said earlier, saprophyte in the sense which grow on dead decaying matter. The decomposer, that means they are helpful in decomposition of the body. So then, parasite, the one which grows on other. Then, coprophyllus. Coprophyllus in the sense, those which grow on dung matter, that is undigested matter. They are called as coprophagous. Then all are multicellular except what? Yeast. Yeast is supposed to be the unicellular phylum. That is only the one which is unicellular. Yeast, I hope you are aware, it is commonly called as sugar fungus. It causes what? The alcoholic fermentation. It is helpful in the production of ethyl alcohol. And even it is commercially used in the bakery industries to make the bread soften and spongy. Then, remember, mycelium is what? Mycelium, as I said earlier, body of the fungus. And the members of the mycelium or the filamentous structure of mycelium are hyphae. Here the hyphae are what? Branch and septate. Septate in the sense what? There are septal walls. Then asexual reproduction occurs by conidia. As like the sporangiopore on which sporangium develops, there is said to be conidiophore, where conidia develops and the conidia produce conidial spores. Whereas the sexual reproduction occur by ascospores. Remember, where ascospores are developed? In the packet-like structure or in the sac-like structures or bag-like structures called as zygote. Here, there may be either what? Four or even the eight spores. These are all what? The ascospores. And this bag can be called as what? Ascus. And the entire can be called as asco. So, this is the ascus. Remember, and the entire, this ascus and ascospores together called as ascocarp. This is the part. These are by sexual reproduction. And remember, the buds are what? Endogenous. Endogenous means developed inside. If at all developed outside, as like that of the spores, they are exogenous. Here they developed inside in the ascus, that is bag-like structure. Hence, they are endogenous. Endogenous. The example is aspergillus, that is black mold. Sometime I told you in the beginning, the bread sometime, if at all it is kept for a longer period of time, on the surface of the bread, you can see what? The black mass. That black mass is caused by the fungal infection by name aspergillus. Then yeast. Yeast, as you are aware, is a sugar fungus which is used for the production of what? The ethyl alcohol. Neurospora is extensively used as an experimental fungus. Then penicillium is the blue mold of RA. It develops on the RA. And the penicillium, that is, penicillin is extracted from this, the penicillium notatum, which is the first antibiotic to be discovered. So these are all the examples for the second class, that is ascomycetes. Now, let us pass on to the basidiomycetes. Here, the basidiomycetes are commonly called as what? Club fungi. Because of its basidiocarp, which is almost club in shape. That means both the ends are almost round. The second feature is either parasite or saprophyte. Then mycelium, body of fungus, branches or filamentous structure called eye pair. They are branched and then with septal valves hence called septate. Reproduction, vegetative by fragmentation. Fragmentation in the sense, if at all the body is cut into several fragments or segments, each fragment can be grown into a new individual. And here in this vegetative mycetes and even ascomycetes like that, the plasmogamy is not suddenly followed by one. Can you think? Plasmogamy, as I said earlier, it is nothing but the fusion of protoplasm of gametes. It is not suddenly followed by karyogamy. After the fusion of the protoplasm of the two gametes, now it forms one cell. But that one cell contains two nuclei. And that stage is called dikaryon stage, or dikaryotic stage. And of course, later the two nuclei, gametic nuclei, fuse together, then it is called karyogamy. When karyogamy is completed, that results in the formation of a diploid what? Zygote. This zygote by meiosis forms what? Haploid spores. Where these haploid spores are formed? On the fruiting body by name basidiocarp. And in this basidiocarp, how many the spores are formed? Four spores. Observe here, they are exogenous buds, developed externally, and this is the basidiocarp. Remember, basidiocarp. And these are what are known as the basidiospores. This is the one. So this is about the basidiomycetes. The typical example for the basidiomycetes is what? Agaricus, that is mushroom, aspergillus, etc. Now lastly, let us know about the class deuteromycetes. What is said to be the deuteromycetes? What may be the common name? As like that of the other three classes. The common name of this is imperfect fungi. Why it is imperfect fungi? This is because of the fact that the other three classes, phycomycetes, ascomycetes and basidiomycetes, the members of all these three classes show both asexual and sexual phases or sexual reproduction. But here in the deuteromycetes, there is no sexual reproduction. As there is no sexual reproduction and it has only the asexual reproduction, the term imperfect fungi is given. And then, as usual, they may be either parasites or saprophytes. And the mycelium is branched and septate. Remember, except in the phycomycetes, the mycelium is what? Aseptate and cenocytic. But in all the other three classes, the mycelium is what? Branched and septate. It has only one type of reproduction, that is asexual reproduction, which is occurred by the formation of vanadia spores. No sexual reproduction. Remember, because of the absence of the sexual reproduction, it is called the imperfect fungus. The rest are what? The fungus in general, that is complete fungus in the sense. Because of what? Because all of them add both sexual and asexual reproduction. But here, these have only asexual reproduction with no sexual reproduction. Based upon that fact, they are called imperfect the fungi. The example is Alternisia and then trichoderma. Trichoderma is the one, is a parasite which grows on the skin of man, causing a disease called ringworm disease. That is a parasite that causes the ringworm disease. So these are the four classes of what? Mycota or fungi. This marks the end of the third kingdom, that is mycota, under the biological classification. Thank you, one and all.